How you folks doing? My name is James Clem. Thank you for watching this video. I want to talk about a topic that makes me sleep better at night, and that is my bond to a ceramic. I do a lot of ceramics in my career, and I want to make sure that bond to that ceramic is phenomenal. This product I've used for 10 years. I have not seen a delamination from the ceramic yet, and that's Monobond Etch and Prime. One thing I wanted to do here at my home studio was bring in the products that I really felt secure with. This is the first of series of unboxing videos of where it shows up on my phone. I go out to the delivery chapel and I pick it up, and we'll do several more unboxing videos, but this is my lifestyle up here at my digital studio. Here I have a number of boxes from Ivoclear. Today we're gonna unbox the Monobond Etch and Prime because it's such a great product. I've used it for a decade of my career. That's a fourth of my career, and it's been so reliable. And I'm going to go through in this video why it's so reliable. But this is what I do up at my homestead. I get to mix country in with dentistry. I do not shift primers easily, whether it be for dentin and enamel or for ceramic, but this one has worked really well for me. And I want to review that with you folks on this video tutorial on my method, because when we pay attention to the details, it's all about the details. It needs to be routine. We have to be precise. We have to look at the minute things. And when we do that in adhesive dentistry, it works really well. So this is about the Monobond Etch and Prime. Why do I like it so much? Number one, it's really safe. We don't have a hydrofluoric etch with this system. It's ammonium polyfluorite etching system, but there's an advantage to that because within the Monobond Etch and Prime, that also stabilizes the silane coupling agent when it's stored. Why is that so important? I don't want my bottle to get outdated, if you know what I mean. I don't want to lay awake at night and say, did I check that bottle's date? Because you want these things to work very well for you. So let's look a little deeper at the Monobond Etch and Prime. So the steps are really easy. Number one is make sure you shake the bottle really well before you use it. You want to make sure it's well mixed. Then take a micro tip brush and then apply a drop of that silane onto that micro tip brush before applying. If you try to drop it into the ceramic, it's going to get really messy and everywhere. And I do want to keep it primarily on the adhesive surface of the ceramic because it makes the cement a lot easier to clean up. So why the scrubbing? The scrubbing is there to clean the surface. And that's one thing nice about this agent is that I don't have to place my ceramic in an acetone bath and clean it any other way. You can actually take it from the try-in in the mouth and actually take this to clean it. So the first 20 seconds, I'm gonna scrub. And you're scrubbing that surface, and that ammonium polyfluoride is starting to clean and starting to condition the ceramic. So after the scrub of 20 seconds, we're gonna let it dwell for 40 seconds. What's the purpose behind that? It's actually starting to etch the ceramic and roughen that surface up for an optimal bond. In addition to that, during this period of dwelling, it starts to deposit the silanol compounds onto the ceramic surface. So it's starting to get that ceramic bond started as it matures. But we're not done with the process. As you start to rinse the system, it's removing that ammonium polyfluoride. And as that is removed, it starts that next phase of the silane bond. So here's an important step that you have to pay attention to. When you dry the ceramic, you need to dry it for 10 seconds. So what's happening during that 10 seconds? And by the way, make sure your air doesn't have any moisture in it. I have a dedicated line for drying, and that way I'm not worrying about getting contamination there. I'm also using loops. I'm using that Lumadent 10 magnifier, which I love. It's that ergonomic one, and I can see precisely every little nook and cranny on my ceramic to make sure I'm doing this right. So as we're drying for 10 seconds, this is what's happening. The silane is undergoing the final condensation to optimize that coupling covalent bond to the ceramic material. In addition to that, it's undergoing a very robust layer of methacrylate end groups. And what that means is on the outside of that ceramic, as you see in the illustration here, the methacrylate end group is there to bond to your resin. Whatever you're going to use for bonding, that's going to be very solid, and this is a very dense application. And that's the beauty of this system. You have that strong bond to your ceramic because it's been conditioned properly with the steps, and then with the maturity of your adhesive layer, the covalent bond on the ceramic, you have those methacrylate groups, and those are important because that's what bonds to your resin cement. So after 10 years of using this product in my clinical theater, I can fully endorse it as a product that fits the category of I sleep better at night. So now that we've reviewed how this product works, I'm going to review one more time the process in my clinical theater. It's something that I could not live without now. And if you haven't used it, it will really simplify the process for you. And in addition to that, not having hydrofluoric etch, which can be quite a toxin, is really nice to know, because that way I know a staff member or a patient's not going to be contaminated. An excellent way to hold the ceramics while conditioning them is the Optra Stick by Ivoclare. You can see with some movement there, it will not break loose during the process. You can bend them at right angles and place them on the occlusal surface for posterior teeth, and that makes the placement a lot easier. But the most important thing here is that they don't break loose while you're conditioning the ceramic or applying in the mouth. Mix the bottle well before applying. Then with a microtip brush, what we're going to do is take a drop on the end of that microtip brush. That's all you need for one ceramic. It keeps it clean and neat. Keep the material on the internal surface. Try not to let it get on the external. Otherwise, it will make cement a little more difficult to clean up. You're going to lightly scrub and rub and both for 20 seconds. The dwelling for 40 seconds is there to complete the etch and mature the silane bond. Dry thoroughly with a non-contaminated air process to complete the maturity of the silane coupling agent and the methacrylate bond. It needs to be for 10 big seconds, so definitely time it. And now we're ready to go. We're ready to place our cement and deliver in the mouth. The other question I'll get on this product is, what do you do if something's coming from the lab and it's already been etched? You can use Monobond Etch and Prime on a restoration from the lab that's already been hydrofluoric etched. You've tried it in, it will clean up any debris on it, and it will also optimize that silane coupling process on the surface to get a strong bond. So you can use it on a ceramic that's already been etched with hydrofluoric etch. Since all the ceramics in my practice are made with my efforts, it's something I really love to do. This is a really easy process of where once you've tried it in, you process the ceramic with Monobond Etch and Prime and you bond. Now, what happens if it gets contaminated? I can go back and reapply the Monobond Etch and Prime, same process, without contaminating or over etching the surface, to still optimize the bond. So the Monobond Etch and Prime can be effective for everyone, whether you're doing ceramics in-house or whether you're getting a ceramic from the lab. It's just another way to put that silane coupling agent onto the ceramic. You know it's assured, you know it's going to be strong and reliable, and that's really what I'm looking for in this process. If you have any comments or questions, make sure you post them below, and I'll see you in another video real soon. You folks take care. Bye.